Excel provides us with two functions for calculating accrued interest, accrued and ACCRINTM. But what exactly is accrued interest? Accrued interest is the interest that has been earned but not yet been paid by the bond issuer since the last coupon payment. Because the security hasn't expired or the next payment is not yet due, the owner hasn't officially received the money. If he or she sells the security, accrued interest should be added to the sale price. So, in our example, we see all the information on the bond we bought. The previous coupon payment was a few months earlier. We have two scenarios for this bond. One that pays periodically and one that pays at maturity. We have calculated the price in both of them using the price function. Take note here that the price function returns the per $100 value, so we multiply the result by 100 to have the per $10,000 value, which is our initial investment. Our initial investment is also called par value of investment or principal of an investment. In cells B14 and C14, we have calculated the clean price, which is the price without the accrued interest. Below them, we calculated the accrued interest and then the dirty price, which is the total price of the bond, including accrued interest. We have used both of the accrued interest functions to achieve this. One for the bond that pays periodically, and the other for the bond that pays at maturity. To see how exactly we did this, let's go to the next sheet where we have another bond for sale. As you can see, the accrued interest is yet to be calculated. Thus, the dirty price is still equal to the clean price. All the other details we have seen in the previous sheet are here, but with slight differences. For example, our initial investment is $1,000 instead of $10,000. We go to cell B15 to find out what the accrued interest for the bond that pays periodically is. We type the name of the function, followed by the issue date in cell B4, and the first interest date in cell B5. This is where we have to mold the function to our demands. The accrued function of Excel calculates the amount of interest that has been earned since the day that bond was issued. This would not be correct or fair to the buyer, since we would calculate in the accrued interest money we had already received up to the date of the settlement. In our example, we want to sell the bond in February of 2016, cell B7. Which means that we have already received all the coupon payments previous to that date. So the accrued interest should be calculated from the date of the previous coupon payment, which is the last we have received in January of 2016, up to the date of the settlement, February 5 of 2016. To mislead Excel into doing our bidding, we set as both issue date and first interest date of the bond the date of the previous coupon payment. So, to correct our function, we will set the two first arguments to cell B6, which is the previous coupon payment. Then the date of settlement, which is the date our sale is going to take place, as we said before, February 5 of 2016, the rate in cell B9, the par value of the investment in cell B3, and the frequency of payments from cell B10. The next argument, basis, is optional and it helps us choose the type of day count to use. We will always use the default 0 value. And then the last value, calc method, which is optional as well, is a logical value that specifies the way to calculate the total accrued interest when the date of settlement is later than the date of the first interest. A value of true returns the total accrued interest from issue to settlement. A value of false returns the accrued interest from first interest to settlement. If you do not enter the argument, it defaults to true. In our case, both methods provide us with the same result since our issue date and the first interest date are the same. So, we can omit both of the optional attributes and click on enter. We have calculated the accrued interest and you can notice that the total price, the dirty price, has changed accordingly. Then we have to calculate in cell C15 the accrued interest for a bond that pays at maturity. We use the appropriate function ACCRINTM, followed by its arguments. Here we don't need to trick Excel, so we use the proper issue date from cell B4. And then the settlement date. The rate. And the par value. We omit the optional basis argument. We click on enter. And we have our result. The total sale price has changed also here, and we have the total price for both our scenarios.